In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of adductor magnus. This is adductor magnus. Adductor magnus. This is the biggest muscle among adductor muscles. I am going to explain its origin, insertion, function, and anatomical relationship with other tissues. Let me explain origin. Origin of this muscle is here. It's from pubis, especially inferior pubic ramus. It's about here, this area. And it originates from this area. This is ischial tuberosity. Ischial tuberosity. So it's from across pubis and ischial tuberosity. Now let me explain its insertion. Okay, now this is posterior view. Insertion of adductor magnus is this portion and this area. This area is called linea aspera. Linea aspera, especially on medial part. Medial part of linea aspera. And what is this part? This is adductor tubercle. Adductor tubercle. Plus, do you see this space? This space is called adductor hiatus. Adductor hiatus. There are few tissues that penetrate this adductor hiatus. I am going to explain this later. Okay. Anyway, insertion is medial part of linea aspera and adductor tubercle. Now let me explain function of adductor magnus. Okay, main function is, of course, adduction. Because its name is adductor magnus, right? That's why it's adduction. And it's on posterior part of femur, so it can do hip extension. Hip extension. Plus, depends on where the fiber is, that also can do hip flexion. Hip flexion. I know it is weird, but some adductor muscles can do both extension and flexion. This is very, very interesting. And adductor magnus is very big and it can do extension. So some people consider this muscle as fourth hamstrings. Fourth hamstrings. You know, there are biceps femoris, semimembranosus, semitendinosus, and some people consider its function as fourth hamstrings because it can do extension. It's good to know, right? Anyhow, one more function for hip joint, that is stability. Adductor muscles are very important for stability of hip joint and also for pelvis. And it can do external rotation. Oh my gosh, there are so many functions. Not only adduction, it can do extension, flexion, depends on fiber, stability and external rotation. This is very important for hip and pelvic movement and stability. Now let me explain relationship with nervous tissue. This is posterior view as well. What is this nervous tissue? This is sciatic nerve. sciatic nerve. Sciatic nerve runs just posterior to adductor magnus. Okay, it's like this. And what kind of muscles run posterior to sciatic nerve? It's like this. What are these muscles? These are hamstrings. Okay? So, adductor magnus and hamstrings. And between these two muscles, sciatic nerves run like this. So it's like a sandwich between adductor magnus and hamstrings. What happens when adductor magnus gets tight? Or when hamstrings gets tight? That can create impingement for sciatic nerve. It's very important, right? Most of the time, hamstrings is very famous for impingement for sciatic nerve. Yes, it is true. But if you think about relationship with adductor magnus, this muscle is also important for sciatic nerve, right? Because sciatic nerve runs between hamstrings and adductor magnus. That is why focusing on adductor magnus is also important for sciatic nerve, okay? For next part, I'm going to explain relationship with blood vessels. Okay, do you remember this space? This is adductor hiatus. Adductor hiatus. What kind of tissues run in this hiatus? It's blood vessels. What kind of blood vessels? They are femoral artery and femoral vein. Femoral artery and femoral vein. That sounds very important. What happens when adductor magnus gets tight? Maybe this space might be diminishes. What happens when this space gets narrow? That can reduce blood circulation, right? Then what happens when blood circulation is diminished? Maybe that can create joint pain for knee joint because this joint is now lacking oxygen and nutrition, right? So joint pain can happen or numbness can happen. And maybe dysfunction for muscular system can be happening. So I focus on space in human body because many tissues penetrate this kind of space. That is why I focus on this kind of space in human body, not only adductor hiatus, but also for many, many structures. Okay, this is very, very important to know. Okay, in this video, I explained basic anatomy of adductor magnus, its origin, insertion, function, and anatomical relationship with nervous tissue and blood vessels. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.